डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस दैट इज द क्यूनोलोन्स। क्यूनोलोन्स क्या होते हैं और क्यूनोलोन्स का मेनली यूज क्या होता है, और मोस्टली इस कैटेगरी से रिलेटेड बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स को ये कंफ्यूजन रहता है कि व्हाट इज बेसिकली दीज आर। ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, वी विल डिस्कस दैट द क्यूनोलोन्स। क्यूनोलोन्स बिलोंग्स टू एंटी बैक्टीरियल कैटेगरी। These are not antibiotics because these are purely synthetic compounds. These are not obtained from microorganisms and these are not semi-synthetic derivative molecules from basic nucleus which can be obtained from microorganisms. Means as per definition of antibiotics, these are not comes under antibiotic category. Okay, that's why these are antibacterial category in your syllabus. These belongs to the category that is urinary anti-infective agents, but at the same time, these are not only urinary anti-infective agents. These are broadly used in for the systemic infection, that may be either throat infection, that may be different body part infection may be there, but as per your syllabus, that is I think as per my view, it is a not category of anti-infective or urinary anti-infective. These comes under antibacterial category. That's why I am taking a quinolones and their analogs. Try to understand. Okay, quinolones means quinolones. As name suggests, quinolones means it have a quinoline ring system, plus own four, that is a ketone. Means quinolone have quinoline ring system along with ketone functional group known as quinolones. Okay, try to understand. This is our quinoline ring system as we have discussed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, means this is the numbering system of quinoline ring system. At the same time, it have this is the ketone functional group. That's why it comes under the quinolones. Okay, quinolones, but at the same time, it have again fluorine molecule at sixth position. That's why generally these quinolones known as fluoroquinolones. Try to understand, that is fluoroquinolones. Okay, that's why these are known as, these are the examples of, as well as this one also comes under the fluoroquinolones. Why these are fluoroquinolones? As all these drugs having a fluorine at sixth position, similarly that is have a ketone functional group at fourth position and quinoline ring system. That's why these known as fluoroquinolone derivative. Okay, try to understand. This is carboxylic group and R1 is the substituent and position first position. Similarly, R5 is the substituent at fifth position. R7 is the substituent at seventh position and R8 is the substituent at eighth position. Try to understand, that is first our drug, that is the norfloxacin. Norfloxacin, that is just I am telling R1 is this one, R5 that is this one, and R7 that is this one, and R8 that is this one. Okay, try to understand. Norfloxacin, that is CH2CH3, that is H means this one, and this piperazine ring system, this R7 is the piperazine ring system and R8 is the hydrogen. Similarly, perfloxacin second molecule, that is the perfloxacin, that is have two carbon means ethyl moiety is there, then hydrogen and substituted methyl on what, that is on piperazine ring system and hydrogen. Similarly, that is the third molecule, that is ciprofloxacin. Cipro, you can understand, cipro means cyclopropyl is ring is there, then cyclopropyl, this one, cyclopropyl, hydrogen, piperazine and hydrogen. Okay, similarly fourth molecule, that is the gatifloxacine. Gatifloxacine have methoxy as well as methyl group on piperazine, and eighth position of methoxy group, that is gatifloxacine. And fifth position compound is a lomefloxacine, that is methyl and fluorine. These are the different one. Lomefloxacine at the same time, sixth molecule or drug molecule, that is sparfloxacine, that is cyclopropyl, amino as well as fluorine. It is an entirely different molecule, that is sparfloxacine. Why it is entirely different, we will discuss in SAR of quinolones or fluoroquinolones. Why it is so, and why we are substituting NH2 group and why we are substituting fluorine group. Okay, similarly, that is the seventh molecule, that is moxifloxacine, that is cyclopropyl as hydrogen, and this is the bicyclo form, that is another ring system, heterocyclic ring system, and that is the methoxy group, that is moxifloxacine. Okay, come to the next molecule, that is ofloxacine. Generally, it is very common drug, that is ofloxacine. Why we have written this separately? Because it have a combined structure in this system also, that is ofloxacine, but at the same time it comes under the fluoroquinolones, because this fluorine moiety is there and quinolone part is also present. That's why it comes, that ofloxacine comes under the fluoroquinolones. Okay, this is all about what we have discussed, that is the fluoroquinolones, and these are totally synthetic molecules. That's why these are not antibiotics. Means ciprofloxacine is a not antibiotic, lopafloxacine, nanofloxacine, gatifloxacine, lomefloxacine, sparfloxacine, moxifloxacine and ofloxacine, these are totally antibacterial category, not antibiotic. Okay, come to the next category, that is naphthahydrine. What is the naphthahydrine? As you know, what is the naphthalene? Benzene ring. Okay, this one is the benzene ring, fine. And another benzene, this is the side by side, this is the naphthalene. Okay, this is naphthalene. If I give the numbering to the naphthalene, then it will be the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. If two carbons are substituted by nitrogen, that is naphthahydrine. Here we are substituting first position as well as eighth position. That's why generally it is known as 1,8 naphthahydrine. Okay, that is naphthahydrine. Only two molecules are there, that is nalidixic acid, that is used as a urinary antiseptic purely, as well as enoxacine. If there is only two difference, means R6 and R7, that is the position of respectively, that is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, means 6th and 7th position have a different one for the nalidixic acid as well as enoxacine, means R6 this one and R7 this one. Okay, means R6 have a hydrogen in the nalidixic acid, enoxacine have the fluorine group at 6th position. Similarly, R7 means R7 this part, in general, most of quinolones or fluoroquinolones have the piperazine ring system, as we have discussed that this is the piperazine ring system. But at the same time, here nalidixic acid is the methyl group, while enoxacine have the again piperazine moiety. Okay, this is all about the naphthahydrine derivative. Okay, that is last category, that is xenolines. What is the xenolines? Try to understand. Here benzene ring, this one the benzene ring, fine. This and it is again similar structure as fluoroquinolones, but here X is a different one. Here X is a different one. X here means here X have the CH CH means that the very simple structure means like this, but different of this ring system, that is oxolinic acid. Okay, means that is cinolines. Okay, then what is the cinoline? Cinoline, if have a X group equal to nitrogen, that will be cinoxacin. Oxolinic acid converts into cinoxacin when X equal to nitrogen. When nitrogen, this one, then all valences are completed by the double bond as well as single bond. That is the cinoxacin. Okay, means this is the category. Means try to understand. Quinolones is the main category, and naphthahydrine and cinolines are its analog. That's why I have written analog. Analogs are these naphthahydrine. Naphthahydrine have the nalidixic acid and inoxacin. Similarly, cinolines have the oxolinic acid and cinoxacin. Okay, this is all about medicinal chemistry classification of these quinolones are their analog. Again, I should emphasize on this point, these are not a particular category urinary anti-infective agents. These are generally anti-bacterial category. That's why I am telling that the whole classification of quinolones as well as fluoroquinolones. Then what is the question, or what is the question probability in during exam or university exam? The question may be write short note on fluoroquinolones, then you have to write only first category. And if question is there, write short note on quinolones, then you have to quinolone and its analog. That's why we have given all three categories. Okay, this is all about quinolones and quinoline derivatives. Now, as far as concerned with the urinary antiseptic or urinary anti-infective agents, we will discuss in another lecture, which conclude the whole categories of urinary antiseptic as well as urinary tract infection ke liye hum kaun-kaun si drug categories lenge, that we will consider in the different lecture. Okay.